flax seeds as a part of my diet somehow, but I have not been successful till I found how to make kopra tenga laddus. I kind of don't like the, because I eat mostly raw, I kind of don't like the distinctive odor and taste that flax seeds have. But in this recipe, you can rest assured that most of the times we won't even realize that that we have used flax seeds in this laddus. It's super yummy and it's vegan, whole plant based, raw and full of nutrition and the goodness of nature. Ingredients: kopra tenga, powdered kopra tenga. We can also use coconut butter. However, preparing the coconut butter is a tedious and cumbersome process. So kopra tenga to this powdered consistency serves just fine. 1 full cup of kopra tenga. About 5 tablespoons of flax seeds. And we all know that flax seeds are a powerhouse of nutrition. About 10 to 12 dates or as per your sweetness requirement. And for garnishing, raisins and pistachios. So these are the ingredients we need. Along with this, we can use some roasted peanut powder, roasted sesame seed powder if we already have it, but it's completely optional. We can also use a pinch of salt and have to use a pinch of elaichi powder for sure to give the laddu taste. The first step is to add the flax seeds into the mixer jar and to make a fine powder of the flax seeds. This should be the very first step. And it's very important to first powder the flax seeds. As you can see, the flax seeds are well powdered. And if it's not well powdered, we can always scrape the edges like this. Yeah, like this, and then pulse again so that it becomes a smooth powder. Now this mixer jar is slightly oily because I had already made one batch of laddus. But see how neat the laddu batter has come out, the laddu mixture has come out. So that it doesn't, it doesn't even stick to the jar. So that's how smooth the mixture is. So that's why I love to make kopra tenga laddus. To this powder, flax seed powder, I'm going to add the kopra tenga little by little and grind till it sheds a lot of oil, which is very easy because kopra tenga is made of oil, right? That the mixture jar does not get heated up too much, so cool and wait and then resume blending. Now to this mixture, I'm going to add some elaichi powder and grind again, and then as per my sweetness requirements, I'm going to add the number of dates, about 10 to 12 dates depending on how much sweetness we require. So after first adding the flax seeds and making a powder, I slowly add the kopra tenga little by little. Can you see how shiny it is? Because the kopra tenga has a lot of oil that gets shed once we keep blending it. We add the dates also and it becomes like, like a bundi-like consistency. We can make the laddus using this mixture, as we can see that the bundi-like consistency has reached. I can grind it once more just to make sure enough oil is available for binding. So from the mixer jar, I transfer the mixture to the bowl. Can you see how much of oil is there in this mixture? I have not added any extra oil and I just added the pistachios and raisins and pulsed just once. So this sheds so much of oil and I'm just going to roll it in the form of a laddu like this and make the laddus, and I'll show you the final product, how it looks. So I have garnished the laddus with some kopra tenga and some pumpkin seeds. These laddus are super yummy, super healthy, and it's actually unbelievable the first time I made it because it's super easy. Such yummalicious laddus, so easy to make, I was unable to believe. Do try it and let me know how it works for you.